Hello everyone, welcome to this Godot Firebase tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to allow the player to create an account, log into the game, and save their game data online. So, why Firebase? Firebase is a backend cloud service backed by Google. It has a free tier, and there's an open source plugin for Godot, which handles the REST API for us. The downside of using Firebase is that it's designed for a more generalized use case, so it's missing some game-specific features compared to other solutions, such as leaderboards, multiplayer, matchmaking, friends, etc. Depending on your needs, you might prefer one over another. Alright, let's dive into the tutorial. I'm going to use this very simple game to demonstrate. In this game, you can click on the panda to pet it, and you can see the number going up. I know, extremely entertaining gameplay. You can also name the panda. For example, let's call it Bamboo. But here's the problem. When you restart the game, you can see that the number resets to 0 and the name is gone as well. Of course, you can save the data locally. There's plenty of tutorials on how to do so. But for this particular game, we are going to save the data online using Firebase. If you want to follow along, you can download the starting template from my GitHub repo. The repo will also have the completed project as well. Link is in the description. The first thing you want to do is create a Firebase project. Go to the Firebase website, sign in with your Google account. Click on Go to Console. Then, create a project. After doing so, you should be looking at your project overview. Now, we want to add an app to the project. Click on the web add button and name it whatever you want. Click on register app. Here's the configuration for your game. You'll need them later. If you forget it, you can find it in the project settings later. Now, let's install Firebase to our game. We are going to use this plugin made by Godot Nuts. You can either get it from the asset library or directly from GitHub. I'll show you both ways. Go to assetlib and search for Firebase and download this plugin. Then, click on this little arrow and make sure only the add-ons Godot.Firebase folder is selected. We don't need the rest of them. Click on install and you are done. Installing the plugin from the asset library is convenient, but the recommended way is installing it from the GitHub repo. Go to the GitHub page. Link is in the description by the way. Go to releases and download the latest version. Extract it, and in the extracted folder, go to add-ons, copy the Godot.Firebase folder. Go to your game root directory, create a folder named add-ons if you haven't already, and paste the Godot.Firebase folder we just copied here. The hierarchy should look like this: root directory, add-ons, Godot.Firebase. Next, go to project, project settings, plugins, and enable the Firebase plugin. You'll see an error complaining that the env file is missing. Unfortunately, it's not possible to do it from the Godot editor. So, in the file explorer, go to the add-ons Godot.Firebase folder, create a new text document and name it .env. From the plugin installation guide, copy the example and paste it to your ENV file. If you are using my template, I've prepared the .env file for you. All you need to do is move it to the Godot.Firebase folder. Remember the configuration we had just now? Copy them one by one into the ENV file. Ctrl S to save the file. In your game export settings, go to resources, and include the ENV file. If you are making a mobile game, remember to enable internet permission in the export settings. Great, now we have the project created and the plugin installed in our game. Next, I'll show you how to implement player authentication. First, we need to enable authentication on the Firebase console. On the left panel, go to Engage, Authentication. Click on Get Started. It's possible to implement the sign-in with Google with the plugin we use. If you're interested in that, let me know in the comments. But for the sake of this tutorial, we'll go with a simple email password method. Enable it and click Save. Now let's create the UI elements. Create a new user interface and name it Authentication. You'll need a line edit for the email, another line edit for passwords, a login button, and a register button. I've also placed a label up here to indicate the authentication state. Next, create a script. Then connect the button's pressed signal to the script. We want this scene to be loaded when the game starts, so go to Project Settings, Application, Run, and set it as the main scene. By the way, this scene and the UI elements are included in the starting template from my GitHub repo. When the login button is pressed, we want to call firebase.auth.login with email and password, and pass in the email and password as the arguments. We want the email and password to be the values in the line edits. Make the line edits unique and drag them into the script. We also want to update the state label, so make the label unique, shift drag into the script, and change its text to logging in. Copy the code to the onRegisterButtonPress function and change the text from logging in to signing up. We also want to know if the login and sign up is a success or fail. So let's create a few functions. On login succeeded with an argument auth. Same for on sign up succeeded. We also need on login failed with two arguments, error code and message. Then the on sign up failed function with the same arguments. Go to the ready function and connect firebase.auth.loginSucceeded to the onLoginSucceeded function. And basically the same thing for the signup succeeded, login failed, and signup failed signals. When the authentication succeeds or fails, these functions will be called. Let's start with the onLoginFailed function. We want to print the error code and the message. We also want to update the state label. Do the same thing for the onSignupFailed function. Great, let's move on to the onLoginSucceeded function. We want to print the argument and update the state label. Then copy the code into the onSignupSucceeded function and replace the word login to sign up. Great, let's test our implementation. Enter the email and password and press register. Okay, it seems that we need 6 characters for the password. Let's try again. Great, that worked. If we go to the Firebase console, in the authentication tab, you can see the list of the accounts here. Let's press the login button. Login success as well. If you change the password, login failed as expected. By the way, you can turn on secret for the password line edit. Doing so will hide the password when the user is typing in. Alright, the user can now create an account and log into our game. But that would be annoying if they have to type the email and password every time they open the game. Luckily, the plugin provides a very easy way to address the problem. All you need to do is call firebase.auth.saveauth auth in the login succeeded and signup succeeded functions. Then, in the ready function, call firebase.auth.checkauth file. If it returns true, then login is a success. Do note that this doesn't work on HTML builds. Another thing we want to do is redirect the player to the game scene after logging in. So here, you want to write get free, change scenes to file, and go to our game scene. Since now we have the authentication state persisted, we'll need a logout button in the game scene. Add the button, connect the signal, then in the function, call firebase.auth.logout and change the scene to the authentication scene. Alright, let's test our implementation. So after logging in, you can see that we are directed to the game scene. Now, if we restart the game, you can see that we are still in the game scene without needing to log in again. Great, let's click on the logout button. Cool, we are now back to the authentication scene, and restarting the game will bring us here as well. Now we have the authentication implemented, we can move on to the cloud safe part. Firebase offers three different cloud safe services, each having their own advantages. We are going to focus on Firestore in this tutorial, but feel free to explore the other two options. I'll briefly explain the data structure in Cloud Firestore. So, in a database, you can have collections, and each collection contains documents, which contain fields to store some values. For example, in our case, we can call this collection pandastats, and then each document will hold data for individual users. They will use the user ID as their ID. In the documents, the fields can be panda name and padding count. On the Firebase console, go to Build, Firestore Database. Then, click Create Database. Here, you can change where you want the data to be stored. We'll use the default for this tutorial. Click Next. I'll show you how to write your security rules later. We'll go with the test mode for now. Here you can create a collection manually, but we don't have to do it. When the data is uploaded from the game, it will be created automatically. We have our database created. Let's go back to the Godot editor. In the game scene, add a button with the text save and connect its press signal to the script. Now, in the onSaveButtonPress function, we want to save data, but before doing so, we check if the player is logged in before uploading the data. So we can call firebase.auth.auth and get the user ID from it. If it's not null, then we can proceed. To upload the data, the game will need to know which collection to upload to. Type var collection, make it Firestore collection type, and it will be firebase.firestore.collection with the collection ID as the argument. In our case, the collection ID will be pandastats. Next, create a task and call collection.update. We can also use the add function, but it will throw an error when you try to add an existing document. The update function will create the document as well if it doesn't exist. So we'll go with update instead of add. The first argument will be the document ID, and that will be the user ID. The second argument will be the data. It needs to be a dictionary, and we want to include the panda name and the padding count. We already have the padding count in the script. For the panda name, we can get it from the line edit. make it unique, shift drag into the script, and use its text as the panda name value. Great, now let's run the game. Pet the panda a few times and name it Bamboo. Click save. Now, if we go to the Firebase console, in the Firestore page, we can verify that the data is indeed uploaded to the cloud. We have the upload implemented. Let's move on to downloading this data back to our game. In a script, we want to load the data in the ready function. Some of the code is identical to the save data function. We can simply copy it from it. Instead of updating the documents, this time we want to get doc with the user ID as the argument. Next, we can get the document by using await task.taskFinish to get the finished task, and from it, we can get the document. Let's print the output and see what it looks like. Okay, so the document contains a doc name, a doc views, and its create time. To get the value, we simply do document.docviews.name. Update the panda name, line edit with it. Same goes to the padding count. Cool, now if we restart the game, we can see that the values are successfully loaded. When you implement a feature, it's always good to think of how it can fail and we want to handle the error. For example, a new user won't have any data on the database, so the downloaded document will be null. We want to check if it's null before using its value. You can also print the error of the finished task to check what the error is. Remember the security rules when we create the database? We are going to deal with it now. On your Firebase console, go to Build, Firestore Database, Rules. I'm just gonna remove the comments here. For example, if you want to let everyone access your database, you can change the condition to true. If you want to block everyone, you can change it to false. If you want the database to be accessible by only authenticated users, change to request.auth not equals null. You can also set individual rules for the collections or documents. In this example, we allow anyone authenticated to create a document, and the users can only read, update, or delete their own document. If a user tries to read or write other users' data, their access will be denied. The security rules is a complex topic, and I can't cover all the details in this single video. I'm just showing you some common rules. You can take a look at the documentation if the simple rule doesn't suit your needs. So now you know how to implement basic player authentication and cloud save. What's next? Well, you can implement the sign in with Google method, or maybe you want to allow the user to change their password or send a password reset email to them. How about using the real-time database to implement a chat feature? Let me know in the comments if you're interested in any of that. By the way, I've also created a tutorial on Silent Wolf. If you are making a game that requires simple authentication and cloud save, or if you need the leaderboard feature, Silent Wolf could be a compelling option as well. That's all for this tutorial. If you find it helpful, don't forget to leave a like on the video. And please consider subscribing for more game dev tutorials and contents. I'm Boon, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.